G'day, didgeridoo, smart person. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist from the North Pole. Grab a coffee, grab a chair, grab a Vegemite sandwich.
No.
Grab some vodka.
It's a little bit better, yeah.
Today I've brought my reindeer along with me. This is my Russian girlfriend, Masha. Actually, right. Maria. But not just a pretty face. She's actually a medical student. What year? Second year?
Finished second year.
The third year, I'm kidding.
He's trying to get it wrong.
And she's not bad at the old physica. You did physics in high school, right? So she's probably physics, better at physics than me. She's also pretty good with her drugs, aren't you? You like drugs? She has a degree in pharmacology. So
that's my thing, yep.
She was going to be a pharmacist for a while there, weren't you?
Pharmacologist.
So a lot of people get that confused. If you do a degree in pharmacology, it doesn't make you a pharmacist.
Very offended, yeah.
It's an actual science, and that's why you're looking at the science of drugs, right? So if you couldn't tell, it is Christmas time, so we have our Christmas attire on. She's forcing me to wear this.
We love Christmas.
And I managed to find a Christmas hat that fits my head. So, Siraj Distvorm. Siraj Distvorm. Siraj Distvorm. Merry Christmas in Russian.
Yeah.
But Christmas isn't for like 2 weeks after normal Christmas in Russia, is it?
They just go by their own calendar, their own rules.
So she's never seen Rick and Morty before. Being Russian, she really hasn't watched much Hollywood stuff, have you?
Yeah, I just don't really watch many TV shows, but sad life.
So there was an episode early on called Anatomy Park, episode 3 of season 1. So I figured I could save this one for the medical student and we could do a joint episode. And I also want to say she is thinking about starting her own channel. Yeah, maybe.
Maybe, we'll see. No idea.
I'm going to link her channel in the description.
I don't have a channel yet, but we'll make one.
So yeah, go subscribe to her if you want to see more of Masha.
No.
So yeah, let's watch some Rick and Morty.
Facebook.
Ho, 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 everybody.
More like, whoa, whoa, whoa. What is this? My parents are coming.
Calm down, Jerry. This is Ruben, an old friend.
Pearl Harbor.
I check in on him once a year and give him a little medical evaluation.
Aww.
Medical evaluation. So, right up your alley. Should be interesting. There we go. On Santa, how fitting.
I don't get it.
Really?
Don't worry about your Christmas, Jerry. I'll be with Ruben in my workshop while you guys are having another day in Phil Collins' proverbial paradise. Save the guy's life. I need your help. I want you to find Dr. Xenon Bloom. He'll know what's going on.
Where do I find Dr. Bloom?
In Reuben.
Reuben, Minnesota?
Reuben on the table, Morty. Look, I don't have time for you to wrap your little walnut around everything. Just hold your breath until the process is over or your lungs will collapse.
What process?
Ooh.
Is that...
Hey, Dad, where's Morty?
He's busy.
Yeah, this is a real thing. Like, you can actually do that. To people. Have you not heard of that?
Oh, yeah, no, sorry. I've already done that.
No, I'm serious.
So am
I. They taught you? No, I'm kidding. Is that a normal procedure in...
Yeah, we've already tried doing that. Like,
yeah, they taught you that one in third year med?
Yep. Actually second year.
Can you explain that procedure for us? Let's actually talk about the physics of whether or not you could shrink someone down, because it is pretty interesting.
Okay.
So your atoms would either have to shrink or you'd have to reduce the amount of atoms you're made of. And atoms don't really shrink. The average distance between protons and neutrons that make up the nucleus and the electrons, it doesn't really, you can't change it, you can't reduce it. And even if you could shrink someone down to that sort of size, you'd become so dense that you'd probably just fall through the earth and kill everyone. The other option is removing atoms, and that could theoretically work up to a point. There is a minimum, the cops in the background coming after the Russian. Now, there's a minimum number of atoms you kind of need for things like cells and, you know, cell walls of things, or a strand of DNA. And if you shrunk organs, would that affect how they work?
I mean, yeah.
I mean, because if you...
organ to function.
I mean, like with lungs, though, right? Like if you shrunk that, it would cause all sorts of physics problems. If you shrunk them lengthwise by a factor of 2, the surface area would decrease by a factor of 4, and the volume would decrease by a factor of 8. So wouldn't that affect like diffusion with oxygen and carbon? There is another option, actually. I just realized you could create something called muonic matter, which is just like regular matter, but the electrons are not electrons. There are particles like electrons. They look exactly like electrons, but they're 200 times heavier. So they have the same electric charge. So all the chemistry would be the exact same. And the nice thing about this is that you would have the same chemistry, but just 200 times smaller. But eventually it would decay. So that means for a period of time, you could shrink something for a very short period of time. And you know, beyond that, the muons would decay back to their electron entities. You could shrink things by like 200,000 times, depending on how heavy these new electrons are. And you could only do this at cyclotrons, places where we shoot high energy beams at each other. Places where you have beams of particles smashing into each other, traveling very fast, and they wouldn't last very long. Anyway, that's enough of that. She's sick of listening to me.
Imagine living with him.
I'm fun at parties. So you're probably very sick of me. Let's get back into the show.
He's in bad shape, Ooh. Morty.
Oh, jeez, Rick, what did you do?
Thanks, Morty. What kind of monster do you think I am? I'm sitting here trying to save the guy's life. I need your help.
So what has he done to him? Do you reckon he's maybe had like a seizure or some sort of drug? We could talk about drugs. What? You could explain
drugs.
What a... What's a seizure?
Seizure.
Put you on the spot. She was explaining this to me the other week, and it was really incredible. I had no idea. I
guess the main underlying mechanism is there's just too much release of an excitatory neurotransmitter, which is just a molecule which transmits information. So it puts your brain into like the state where everything's excited and everything starts like firing abnormally and you have a seizure.
Right, neuro, so neurons, transmitter, it's transmitting something between neurons.
Yeah.
So it's, is it, aren't they like electrical signals? So this is physics at the end of the day. If you're looking at electrical stuff, you know, excitations of the electromagnetic field.
Yeah.
So our brains, all our bodies completely rely on electromagnetism. If you
didn't
know.
That's true, yeah.
So cool. So, sorry, I cut you off. So neurotransmitters.
Yeah.
Too much of them in the brain, you said?
Yeah. So usually too much of the excitatory one, or I think too little of the inhibitory one. Another neurotransmitter, acetylcholine, which is a fun example. There's this agent called Novichok, if you guys have heard about that. And what it basically does in the body is it just stops the breakdown of acetylcholine. So it builds up, and that's a pretty fast way for people to die.
Maybe we should steer away from that one. There's a, it's a bit of a touchy subject with your heritage. And yeah, if you don't know what I'm referring to, maybe look that one up. But I think we should steer away from that on social media. Was there anything else? All right. So maybe we get back to the show. You can stop telling people how to poison other people.
Morty, can you hear me? Head north.
Rick. Where am I?
Depending on my aim, you should be just south of the entrance.
Entrance to what?
Welcome, Morty. Welcome to Anatomy Park.
This is beautiful.
I actually just showed her
Jurassic
Park.
Dr. Bloom, an amusement park inside a human body. Science is cheap, Morty. This should really help put a dent in the overhead.
Oh my God! This is insane. Spleen Mountain. Ladder Falls, Pirates of the Pancreas.
You got a problem with that last one,
Pirates,
huh?
Too.
No, I'm just reading them out loud in the order that I'm seeing them.
Okay, all right, if I sounded a little defensive, it's because Pirates of the Pancreas was my baby. You know, I got a lot of pushback.
And I am Dr. Xenon Bloom.
Hey, Bloom.
Is that Steve
Rick,
Irwin in the back?
I don't know why.
Australian
but
hero?
The entire security system has shut down. And I'm afraid
Crocodile Hunter.
The exhibits are unlocked.
Exhibits?
Anatomy Park's greatest attraction, young ferocious diseases.
Diseases?
Hey, Doc, I got news for you. Your living museum is officially a wild safari.
Hepatitis A!
Run!
Anything interesting to tell us about hepatitis A?
Get your vaccines.
Get vaccines.
To the respiratory system.
Exactly what happens when you get hepatitis A, isn't that right?
That's strange. Airflow is down 20%.
So the brain isn't getting enough oxygen. That's why security's offline.
Well, I guess we better check it out.
I don't know why Forrest.
Hey! We must save Ruben. This is my life's work. It's all right, my dear. Nearly all human lungs contain a strain of these bacteria, but the scar tissue keeps them dormant. Morty, get down!
Whoa! Respiratory system.
What are those things? Tuberculosis coming in fast.
You just obey. Everyone has some in their lungs, like a strain of it or something, and they lay dormant.
Not everyone, no. I don't feel like that's not true. Right. No. I mean, you can, yeah, you can have it dormant. So if you get infected with tuberculosis and you don't fully fight it off, can stay dormant in your body for a while. And then say when your immune system weakens, it can just reactivate. And then it can also go, it's pretty interesting. It can also seed into different organs. So if it goes into the blood, it can then spread from your lungs to different places, like even your bone and stuff. It's not good.
Wow.
Your spine, yeah, not good.
Anyway, let's keep watching, see what tuberculosis can do.
What is that horrible smell?
You mean the Panda Express? Kidding. I'm kidding. The body is beginning to constrict and fill with gas. We're inside a corpse, my boy. Anatomy Park is doomed.
Does that actually happen? If someone dies, they fill with gas?
I mean, I guess so. Probably.
Interesting. Well, that reminds me. Remember when we were looking into when does someone officially die? Like, is it when their heart stops beating? Is it when their brain loses all activity?
Really interesting, yeah.
And when does someone officially die? When their heart stops beating?
I guess no, because we looked into it and apparently, so your neurons in your brain like stays active. So I think you lose maybe consciousness, but then your neurons have like the surge of activity and there's like this massive release of ions and they contract that like after a person dies. So your brain's still active, I guess.
It's interesting. I remember it was in a rat study. So they decapitated a bunch of rats, poor rats. And they noticed they lost consciousness almost immediately within 10 seconds. And then a minute later, there was this wave of death effect where synchronously, like a wave through the brain, all the ions were released in this depolarization. They lost all their electrical ability, the neurons.
Yeah.
So that's super interesting. What happens if you were to continue pumping blood around their body after someone died? Would that cause neurons to keep firing? Would that keep the brain still active? If you know you did it within the space of that minute before the wave of death, what would happen if you artificially kept pumping the blood? Would that, I mean, I guess you can't really do that sort of study. It's not exactly ethical, is it?
Like signals.
Yeah, it's really interesting. What is consciousness? It's touching at some really weird things we don't quite understand yet.
Exactly.
Anyway, let's keep watching this show. It's pretty interesting. You're enjoying it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I see why people like this,
It's pretty cool, yeah.
Can't get vaccinated against
that. Is that a nice one, is it? You look friendly.
No.
It's actually really bad.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Well, he was bigger. You got anything interesting to tell us about hepatitis C?
It is curable. There's no vaccine for it, but they've got some antivirals. But it's the one that can lead to it's bloodborne. So it's a little bit different from Hep A.
Anything interesting? That was all
can lead to cancer, great. Actually, not good. Oh, so liver cancer.
Oh. Yeah, that was pretty interesting. Did you enjoy?
I enjoyed that. Yeah.
All right. Well,
pretty funny.
Might have to get her back for another episode or for something else. If you guys want to see more of Maria, let me know down in the comments and subscribe to her channel in the description.
I don't have to do that.
What do you want to end the video with? Anything? You got a good quote for everyone?
He's the quote one in the relationship, so I'm gonna leave the quotes.
What about a Russian quote? Is there a good Russian quote?
Well, I literally don't know any quotes.
Well, I was thinking of Ivan Drago from Rocky. Have you ever seen Rocky?
I actually never seen it, no.
He's a Russian in the movie Rocky, If he dies, he dies. And then he also said, I defeat all men.
Relatable.
That's yeah. You. Anyway, guys, paka.
До свидания.